So let me explain the little domino analogy to you, or the little domino reality. Back in 1983, the American Journal of Physics, they actually did this report. It was an article, and it discovered or said that a domino, just a little 2-inch domino, can knock over a domino that's 50% larger than that domino. And so you think, well, okay, 2 knocks over 3, 3 knocks over 4.5, 4.5 knocks over slightly larger. You could, in theory, continue this trend indefinitely. Well, in 2001, at the San Francisco Exploratorium, they actually ran an experiment with 8 dominoes. The final domino, the 8th one, was 3 feet tall. So they did. They went from 2 to 3 to 4.5, all the way up successively to 3 feet tall, and the dominoes fell. I watched it on YouTube. I thought, let's do the same thing for an advance. We've been teaching this material and been teaching that small things have this exponential impact when they're done consistently well over time. I mean, women watching this right now are thinking, man, if my husband made the bed every single day, that would revolutionize things from a made-up bed. And so I did it. I built an 8-foot-tall domino and backed it all the way down. And the first one was small, and then the next one was 50% larger, 50% larger. And when I pushed the little one, it started slowly going, but eventually it got the momentum, and that big one, though not falling rapidly, it teetered and then it fell. A small action or a small domino has the ability to knock over a big dream. Now, in their book, The One Thing, Gary Keller and Jay Papasan, they actually say you could continue this trend forever. In fact, I'll show it to you. I'll put it on the screen right there for you. If you look at it, domino number one is 2 inches. Domino number 10 would be like my 8-foot domino, a little smaller than that. Domino number 10 would be the height of an average man. Domino 18 is the height of the Leaning Tower of Pisa. Domino 23 reaches the Eiffel Tower. Domino 31 is 3,000 feet above Mount Everest. Domino 57 reaches all the way to the moon. You see? Because you started off with one domino. Now, here's the factors in that. You got to put the dominoes in the right order. Okay, so 2 inches is not going to knock over 8 feet tall. 2 inches is not going to hit the moon. You got to put the dominoes in the right order. But then also, you got to make sure when you got them in the right order that that little domino, that little catalytic action is what we call it, it actually gets done. You see, a catalyst in a science lab. It is something that has the power to make something else that would never begin otherwise. It actually has the power to make that thing start. And so pushing over that little domino, it is the action that makes everything seem to start falling in place. And in each of your dreams, I guarantee you, there is a little domino. Let me show you, like, back to mine. I actually trace it out in this book in chapter 6. I told you about the dream of getting healthy. So getting healthy was the dream. The support beams were losing 40 pounds, building muscle, and getting my body systems in place. And so I had these actions that all surrounded the idea of getting healthy. So exercising each morning, charting what I eat. Food was, I had certain foods I wouldn't eat, certain that I would. I did T25 with Beachbody, you know, using the bands and the free weights to make sure I eat enough calories, detoxing sugar, carbs, caffeine, all these actions. I had to define which was the one that exponentially carried more power and influence relative to its tiny, teeny size. Again, being so small that you might tend to overlook it. Here's what I discovered. The most important thing that I did every single day was writing down what I ate. I had a spreadsheet, as nerdish as it sounds. In fact, when people would say, "What did you do to lose weight? What was the plan?" I would tell them, I'd say, "You don't want to know." And they'd say, "No, I want to know. I want to do it." And I would get to it. And I'd say, "Hey, I wrote this down every single day. When I got up in the morning, I exercised. And then one of the things that I would do kind of my morning routine is I would weigh myself when I took a shower, and I would write down what I weighed, what exercise I did, just a note or two about how I felt. Was I sluggish or did I feel strong?" And I would chart out what I had eaten. I would write it down from that day before and put it all in there. And people would say, "No, that doesn't matter." And I would say, No. It matters. It's just so small that you don't see how much it can matter. just like making the bed. That doesn't matter. But no. In that relationship, that small task, because every relationship's unique, that small task was so powerful that it mattered. You see, it's different for every single dream, different for every single person. But there is one thing. Here's what it did for me, is when I started writing it down, I noticed these trends. I would notice how many times I just randomly wanted a snack. I would notice that if I went to bed at a certain time, that I would feel better the next morning and could exercise and feel stronger. I would notice certain foods that my body responded to, certain foods that my body didn't respond to. It would help me make better decisions because I would know if I was going out with friends that evening or going out on a date night and we were going to a certain place that I really liked, I might adjust my food intake throughout the day and take advantage of that in the evening. It helped empower me to make better decisions. And that one repeating action was key to my success. Let me give you another example to show you what this means. Then I'll give you some of the catalytic actions for my own day planner. Because again, this is the information, this is the tool that I use. So when we did that men's advance, San Diego 4.0, that one where we started creating and first teaching all this material, the one where I literally for the first time got a ladder out on the stage and walked up the ladder and labeled it and marked it up during the event. During that one, the support beams for this event were, number one, was transportation. Because the actions were we had to check airfare, needed to see if I could use my Southwest points, needed to figure out how to get from the airport to the hotel. Could I Uber there? How was I going to get there? Because I wasn't going to rent a car. Number two was I needed hotel and lodging. But the action was to find a hotel that had event space for about 150 guys. So that meant I didn't need a big convention center. That meant I couldn't use something like a Hampton Inn, which is a great hotel, but they just don't have event space for more than 15 or 20 people. I needed something that was in the middle. So an action became finding hotel space, making the phone calls. Another action step here, strangely enough, about the event space became, and I've written the names here, Scott and Spencer. Two of our friends, Scott, I'll give you their last name, Garner and Spencer Thornburg, live in the San Diego area. And so right there, the catalytic action was speaking regularly with Scott and Spencer, who had agreed to be kind of the boots on the ground in that area for that event. Up until that event, the guys that were running the event, that were putting it on, myself, Les, and Barrett, we had done all of the work for the event. If there was a phone call that was made, one of us did it. If there was something that got purchased, one of us did it. If it was a reservation that was called and put in, one of us made the reservation. If there was something that got taught, one of us taught it. That event, it changed because suddenly we were working across country and we had these two guys that were doing a lot of the work for us that had wanted to do it for us. Related to the food, we just needed to see if there was a place at the hotel. Some hotels don't have places where you can eat. Well, we had, 100 plus guys coming in. We needed stuff there. We needed to know if we could make reservations somewhere else to have a night where we could just kind of get everybody out and have fun. We needed to know if there was coffee nearby, just to be honest. So those were all important action steps. And so you look at that and you think, well, what was the catalytic action? What was the little domino? The one that required a little bit of time, but it made everything else, the one that was the most important for that dream, uniquely for that dream, the one that wasn't going to help any of the other dreams, but is the one that was just outweighed the others in this one. And I'll tell you what I figured out it was talking to Scott and Spencer regularly, communicating with them via text message and via telephone, picking it up and talking with them through what they were finding, what they were learning. That, meaning somehow regular communication with people can become the little domino. So the little domino can be a spreadsheet, something you do. The little domino can be making the bed. The little domino can be talking to certain people about a business event that you're doing. Other ones that I put in mind here, other little dominoes that I have circled financially, for growing in a certain capacity this year. There are certain actions that I have related to some of the marketing activities that I do with emails and live videos. I've got a plan where I've written that down. And that little thing that takes so little time, it is the driver. On this other one, physical health, I'm still on that charting it out, mapping it out, what I eat and what I do. with my kids and some of the things that I do with them. Texting them every single day is the little domino. On this other one about a dynamic faith life, it's when I get up and I do a specific thing every single morning, right after exercise, after I get a shower, after I grab the coffee. So it's not the first thing that I do, but it's in that sequence of first things that I do. I'll